Hello everyone, this is Vincent Chan from Pokder.net. Today we'll be talking about the Honor Magic Book, a laptop which impressed me with its value for money and also its battery life. So let's go! So I think you guys may know Honor better as a smartphone brand or maybe also a wearable brand, but they are definitely not known for their laptops, at least not here in Malaysia. So with the Honor Magic Book, we didn't really know what to expect, but I must say I was pleasantly surprised by this RM2299 laptop. Unboxing the Honor Magic Book, I would say that Honor scored the win right off the bat by bundling a 65W USB-C charger in the box. The charger can also charge your phone complete with fast charging support, and it's also pretty compact, which makes bringing it with you to charge not only your laptop but also your smartphone a no-brainer. So now let's take a look at the Honor Magic Book. I would say that it features a pretty nondescript design, and I'm sure some would fancy the clean and sleek design here, and I think I kinda like it too. The Honor logo is offset in one corner, leaving you plenty of space to decorate laptop with stickers. Just don't overdo it like one of our friends. Flipping it over, we see two long strips of perforations along the side as well as rather tall rubber feet, and under the holes are the speakers, but the fan also draws in cool air from these vents. Cooling is rather limited because of this, but we will get to that in a bit. Every surface on the Honor Magic Book is aluminium with the exception of the screen and the bezels around it, which is a nice touch for those desiring a premium laptop without the cost. The whole package weighs just 1.45kg and measures less than 16mm thin, which means it's extremely easy to slip into a bag without really noticing the extra weight. Aside from the portability, another thing that's also surprisingly good on the Honor Magic Book is the keyboard. 14-inch laptops generally have more cramped keyboards, but Honor managed to space the keys out pretty well, with the only keys that aren't really standard size being the FN keys. The FN key arrangement is pretty unique too, as the FN modifier is a toggle instead of one which you hold down to trigger the second layer of functions on the top row of keys. With that out of the way, typing on the Honor Magic Book is a pretty nice experience, although a touch more tactility and travel would have been ideal for the keyboard here. The trackpad is also pretty decent, although the multi-finger tracking can be slightly wonky as holding a finger on the clicker can sometimes cause the entire trackpad to spaz out and not work. In addition to that, the fingerprint scanner is a very good one, with it integrated into the power button and all you need to do is press down firmly to turn on the laptop, and it caches your fingerprint until you reach your lock screen so you don't need to touch it again just to unlock it. Now flanking the keyboard are more speakers. While we mentioned the speakers on the bottom of the laptop, these here handle the higher frequencies and are strategically placed to better send the sound to your ears. With the low frequencies handled by the speakers on the bottom of the laptop and these here handling the upper registers, audio is actually surprisingly good for a laptop of this size, perfect for catching up on some Netflix. Speaking of Netflix, let's take a look at the screen. The screen sports relatively thin bezels around the sides, but the top and bottom ones aren't quite nearly as narrow. That did allow Honor to cram webcam above the screen, so you don't have to deal with awkward camera angles when using the webcam. The panel itself is rather lackluster though, with a maximum brightness of just 267 nits and a low 57.3% sRGB gamut coverage. While the numbers paint a bleak picture, the actual experience isn't quite as bad. The contrast ratios are fine and you will be able to enjoy movies without the image looking washed out or dull, although you might find that image editing just isn't going to be the Honor Magic Book's forte. Now I must say that isn't because of a lack of performance, as it packs an AMD Ryzen 5 3500U, 8GB of DDR4 RAM and a sweet 512GB PCIe 3.0 X4 SSD. The APU offers a strong CPU and GPU combo, and the RAM is sufficient for most intents and purposes, as well as the storage is pretty quick too. You can actually squeeze out a bit of gaming from the Honor Magic Book in esports titles like Dota 2 or Rainbow Six Siege 2. While the performance is impressive, battery life is also pretty good, courtesy of the large 57.4Wh battery in the Honor Magic Book. It clocked over 6 hours of battery life in PCMag, even with the screen set to the maximum brightness, which is an excellent showing. Cooling is not the best, but the system doesn't run into thermal throttling issues just yet. It clocked a maximum of 85.5 degrees Celsius, and the area above the keyboard can get rather warm, as that's where the heatsink fins are located. The entire system runs rather quietly though, so you will be fine working with the Honor Magic Book even in the library. Moving on, I would say that Honor didn't throw in a whole lot of ports on the Honor Magic Book, but all the ones that matter are here. You get one USB-C port which also supports the USB 3 protocol in addition to being the charging port, the HDMI output, and also a regular USB 3 port here on the left. While over on the right, you get a USB 2 port along with the headphone jack. More ports never hurt, but I would say that Honor does seem to have tried its best in terms of cramming ports into the swell design of the Honor Magic Book. Another feature which I feel like I must absolutely highlight on the Honor Magic Book is Honor Magic Link 2.0. It's essentially Honor's version of Huawei Share and lets you pair Honor or Huawei smartphone which support NFC with the Honor Magic Book to transfer files or even use multi-screen collaboration feature, which I do find really nifty. If you do a lot of file transfers between your laptop and smartphone, you owe it to yourself to try this out, as all you need to do is tap your smartphone on an NFC tag on the laptop and they will pair, and all you need to do is drag and drop files between the devices seamlessly. I would say that it's quite a nice feature to have, especially if you already own an Honor or Huawei smartphone right now. Now I think by now you have realized that I quite like the Honor Magic Book. As far as I'm aware, the Honor Magic Book is probably one of the most affordable laptops offering the AMD Ryzen 5 3500U APU, along with 8GB of RAM and 512GB of storage. At RM2299, the Honor Magic Book is quite the value buy for people needing an affordable and portable laptop to use on the go. The battery life is great, the speakers sound splendid, and there's Honor Magic Link being the cherry on top for Honor smartphone users. Sure, the cooling isn't great and the screen is far from a content creator's dream, but considering the price tag, I will just say this to you, what more can you ask for? And that's it for our review of the Honor Magic Book. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, like our Facebook page, and follow us on Instagram. And I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye!